ओके, गुड आफ्टरनून। हाँ सॉरी, गुड मॉर्निंग। टुडे वी विल सी एग्जांपल नंबर 7, दैट इज ऑन द फोर्स एनालिसिस। प्लीज राइट डाउन द प्रॉब्लम एंड ड्रॉ द डायग्राम। आई विल वेट फॉर 5 मिनट्स। Okay, good morning. Now I will read the problem. Example number 7. The pitch circles of a train of spur gears are shown in figure. Gear A receives 3.5 kilowatt of power at 700 rpm through its shaft and rotates in the clockwise direction. Gear B is the idler gear, while the gear C is the driven gear. The number of teeth on gears A, B and C are 30, 60 and 40 respectively. While the module is 5 mm, calculate first torque on each gear shaft and second the components of gear tooth forces. Assume 20 degree involute system for the gears. Therefore, this is the diagram, gear train diagram. This is the gear A, which is the driving gear. Therefore, this motor shaft is connected to this gear A. Therefore, gear A receives 3.5 kilowatt. Gear A rotates in clockwise direction. Now, gear A is in contact with gear B. Since these two gears are external gears, gear B will rotate in anti-clockwise direction. Gear B will rotate in like this, anti-clockwise direction. And gear B drives gear C. Now, since gear B and gear C are external gears, because type of contact is external or they are having external teeth, therefore you are knowing when two gears are meshing externally, therefore their direction of motion is opposite. Therefore, since gear B rotates anti-clockwise, gear C will rotate clockwise. Like this. Therefore, this is the rotation. Now, whatever power gear A receives, that power or that torque is transmitted to gear C through an idle gear C, through an idle gear B, sorry, through an idle gear B. Therefore, now we will calculate torque on each gear shaft. Now, always remember, what is the function of idle gear? Idle gear function is to bridge the gap between driving and driven gear. That is the first function. And second function is, if we will use idle gear, therefore we will achieve the desired direction of motion of driven gear. Means what? Now, in gear A and C, only one idle gear is used. Therefore, direction of motion of gear A and C is same. That is, if odd number of idle gears are used between driving and driven gear, at that time, motion of the driving and driven gear or direction of motion of the driving and driven gear is same. If even number of idle gears are used between driving gear and driven gear, therefore, direction of motion of driving gear and driven gear are opposite. Now, since here only one gear, there is odd number of idle gears used, therefore direction of motion of driving and driven gear is same. Therefore, to achieve desired direction of motion of driven gear, we can use idle gear also. Therefore, these are the two functions of the idle gear. Now, we will solve the problem. I think you have drawn the diagram. Therefore, solution. Solution. Now, we have read first of all given quantities. Having given quantities, they have given us that kilowatt power is equal to 3.5. Then speed of the motor. Speed of the motor means speed of the gear A, because gear A is connected to the, see that gear A receives 3.5 kilowatt at 700 rpm. Therefore, since gear A is connected to the motor shaft, since motor rotates at 700 rpm, therefore gear A will also rotate at 700 rpm. Therefore, in the problem they have given NA is equal to, say, 100 rpm. Then they have given number of teeth on gear ABC. Therefore, ZA is equal to 30. ZB is equal to 60. And ZC is equal to 40. Module M they have given as 5 mm, and pressure they have given it as 20 degree. Therefore, these are the given quantities. Therefore, step one, first of all, we have to determine torque acting on the gear shafts of A, B, and C. Therefore, I down torque acting on shafts A, B, and C. Therefore, first of all, we'll determine diameters or pitch circle diameters of gear A, B, and C, because they have given us module and number of teeth. Therefore, pitch circle diameter of gear A, DA, is equal to what? M into ZA. Therefore, write down 5 into 30. Therefore, DA is equal to, pitch circle diameter of gear A is equal to 150 mm. Similarly, pitch circle diameter of gear B, M into ZB, which is equal to 5 into 60, which is equal to 300 mm. DB is equal to 300 mm. And pitch circle diameter of gear C is equal to M into ZC, which is equal to, this is C, 5 into 40, which is equal to 200 mm. This is 200. Therefore, write down this diameter of gear A, diameter of gear B, and diameter of gear C, that is pitch circle diameters. Now we will determine torque on gear A. Therefore, I think you have written this. Okay, now power they are given. Therefore, kilowatt is equal to 2 pi NA into MTA. डिवाइडेड बाय 60 इंटू 10 रेस टू 6, देयरफॉर किलोवाट इज इक्वल टू 3.5 इज इक्वल टू 2 पाई इंटू एन एम इज 700 इंटू टॉर्क ऑन गियर ए, दैट इज एम टी ए, और टॉर्क ट्रांसमिटेड बाय गियर ए डिवाइडेड बाय 60 इंटू 10 रेस टू 6, देयरफॉर कैलकुलेट. Torque on gear A. This is your one answer. What is the answer? Anyone can tell me fast.
Forty-seven point seventy-five into 10 raised to 3.
How much? 47 point.
47.75
into 10 raised to 3. Correct. 47.75 into 10 raised to 3. Therefore, this is the torque on gear A. Now, we have to calculate torque on gear B. We have to calculate torque on gear B. Now, since gear B is the idle gear, already I have told to do that. What is the function of idle gear? Idle gear is used only to bridge the gap between two shafts or driving gear and driven gear and to achieve desired direction of motion of the driven gear. For that only idle gear is used. Therefore, to write down, since gear B is idle gear, therefore it does not transmit, any torque to its shaft. Therefore, you write down torque on gear B or torque transmitted by gear B is equal to zero. Torque transmitted by gear B is zero. Then you write down, because they have not given efficiency, therefore you have to assume that efficiency is 100%. That means whatever power transmitted by gear A or power at gear A will be equal to power at gear C. Therefore, you write down, since the same power is transmitted from gear A to gear C. Therefore, you write down MTA into NA is equal to MTC into NC. Therefore, write down MTC is equal to MTA in A upon NC. Now this NA upon NC, how will you substitute? We are knowing that gear ratio. NA upon NC is equal to ZC upon ZA. Therefore, substitute this value here. We'll get MTC or torque transmitted by gear C is equal to MTA into ZC upon ZA. This is the gear ratio. N upon NC is equal to ZC upon ZA. Because speed is inversely proportional to number of teeth, or speed is inversely proportional to pitch circle diameter. Therefore, calculate now MTC or torque transmitted by gear C. MTC is equal to, substitute the values, 47.75 into 10 raised to 3 into what is ZC 40 divided by 30. Therefore, MTC is equal to, what is the answer? Hello. Hello, what is the answer?
63.67 into 10 raised to 3.
63.67, yes, correct. 63.67 into 10 raised to 3 Newton mm. Therefore, now we have calculated all the torques. We have calculated all the torques on the gear shaft. Now, step 2. Step 2. What is step 2? Components of gear tooth forces. Components of gear tooth forces. Therefore, we have seen in case of force analysis, first of all, along the pressure line, that normal force is acting. That normal force is divided into two forces, that is tangential force and radial force. Therefore, components of gear tooth forces means we have to find out tangential force and radial force. Always remember. Therefore, you write down the components of the components of gear tooth forces, gear tooth forces between gears A and B are given by write down tangential force. First of all, we'll calculate tangential force, which is equal to what? What is the value of tangential force? We have seen the formula. Tangential force is equal to 2mt upon dp upon d. Therefore, 2mta upon da. Therefore, calculate value 2 into 47.75 into 10 raised to 3 divided by, this is 10 raised to 3, divided by divided by DA. How much is DA? Or pitch circle diameter of gear A? 150. Therefore, calculate tangential force between A and B. Tangential force between A, B is equal to, what is the answer?
636.67.
Yes, 636.67 Newton. Now, we'll calculate radial force. We'll calculate radial force. Therefore, radial force between A and B, that is PRAB. What is radial force formula? PT tan alpha. Sorry, PT tan phi. Here, in some books, they have taken alpha as pressure angle. We have taken phi as pressure angle. Therefore, write down here, which is equal to 636.67 into tan of 20 degree. Therefore, calculate radial force. Radial force between AB. What is the answer?
231.7.
231.73. Yes, correct. Now, this is the values of the forces between A and B. Now, we have seen that gear B is the idle gear. Therefore, whatever torque or whatever power it is receiving, therefore same torque or same power is transmitted to the gear B. Therefore, you write down, since the gear B is idle gear, the gear B is idle, whatever torque it receives from gear A is transmitted to the gear C, is transmitted to the gear C. Therefore, we can write PT tangential force between AB into DB by 2 is equal to PT tangential force between B and C into DB by 2. Therefore, tangential force between AB is equal to tangential force between BC, because same torque and same power is transmitted, because we have considered that 100% efficiency is there. Therefore, which is equal to PT, which is equal to 636.67 Newton. Here that radial force, its unit is Newton. Now, the tangential component is equal. Therefore, radial components will be also equal. Therefore, write down. the tangential component, the tangential component between B and C, between B and C must be equal to the, must be equal to the tangential component, tangential component between gears A and B, tangential component between gears A and B. Therefore, you write down, since the tangential components are equal, this statement we have written as per this equation. This is the equation. The meaning of this statement we have written here. Up to this. Therefore, since the tangential components are equal, tangential components are equal, the radial components, the radial components, that is PT tan alpha, PT tan phi, must be equal, must be equal. Therefore, radial component of force between BC is equal to radial component of force of AB is equal to 231.73 Newton. Write down this. Okay, now we will see how to show the components of forces. Now this is the diagram, already it is there in the book, but still I will explain. Now this is the gear A. This is the gear A. Now see that how try to understand that my line will not be that much perfect. Therefore, now since gear A drives or gear A is the driver, it rotates in clockwise direction. Therefore, I will draw the gear B here now. Try to understand. Now, gear A or two-thirds of gear A will exert force on gear B. In clockwise direction is like this. Therefore, tangential force on gear B is in this direction. Tangential force on gear B is in this direction. And since tangential force on gear B is in this direction, therefore tangential force on gear A will be in opposite direction. Like this. And we are knowing radial component. Radial component, radial force means separating force. Means they will act opposite to each other. They will act opposite to each other. Now, gear A rotates in clockwise direction, therefore gear B will rotate in anti-clockwise direction. Now I will draw gear C here. Suppose this is a gear C. Now since gear B drives gear C, therefore tangential component on gear C will be in this direction. And tangential component on gear B is in opposite to the tangential component of gear C. Therefore this is the tangential component of gear B. And this is the radial force. Radial force means separating force. Or the force which passes through the center, that is known as the radial force. This is the radial force. Therefore, this is the three body diagram of the three gears. Draw this diagram and we will stop here. Thank you very much.